Tori Spelling is being slammed for teaching her daughter racism. She has, however, apologized, but she had shared a photo of her 8-year-old daughter playing dress up in a bandana and with tattoos attached to her fingers, held in place by rubber band. Okay, she apologized anyway, and I like her apology. I mean, it came from a place of understanding that she said she didn't think it through. It was just something that her daughter did based on what she watches and how she's fond of the character, and she decided to put it up. So I hope this apology works, and that people, I don't know if I can use the word back off, but at least they forgive and move on.
I don't know what's up with Black Americans, to be honest. Mm. I'm going to say Black Americans because I don't think Nigerians are like that. Mm. Like, if I did something Igbo and then I said, Chidinma, I don't think Igbos would come for me and be like, oh my God.
I was trying not to say I did not see the pain.
I didn't see any. Well, like, there's okay. So much baggage with these people. Like, I don't understand it. I don't understand how you give so much. First of all, how can you give so much power to words? Like, I don't understand. And then secondly, you can't own Mac anything. Because there's ghetto Latinos that call themselves that. There's ghetto Mexicans that call. So it's not just a Black people thing. And I always talk about it on social, because I see it more on social media when people what's that word? Where you're abusing someone, but it's just actually a reflection of yourself. There's a word for it.
Projection.
Projection.
Yeah.
And I think Black people project a lot. You have a problem with yourself. You have a problem with your ghetto-ness and your name. So when an innocent person is playing with her child and then labels it a name, you freak out. Mm. I don't think she needs to apologize to anyone. I think we need to grow up and get past that and own our words. We try to own nigga, but yeah, you still rage like a crazy person if somebody ever dares call you that. It's like, relax.
The number of times even the Black Americans make jest of white
people.
If they go off like that every time, I don't think we'll have any other issue to discuss ever.
I don't think we're trying to dispel the fact that racism does exist.
Of course,
just like we did talk about colorism the other time. Mm-hmm. So just think about it this way. Anything that would be done, anything that would be projected by way of comedy, satire, that gives a hint to suggest racism, it will affect the people who are the receiving end.
Oh,
and
please.
Yes, I agree with you that Blacks sometimes we can be pretty much reactive.
We overdo it.
But
we overdo
they are the ones over the years, for over how many years?
It's okay. That's a toppy story. Who hasn't been? Come to Africa. What are you talking about? Let's be real. Come to Africa.
Racism
is the reason why we're like this. Let's talk that we're still living the brunt of colonization. So everybody can play the blame.
She did claim she didn't know. I mean, she didn't read so much meaning that.
Because she doesn't have to.
She wasn't thinking that way. She doesn't have to.
So it's fine she wasn't thinking that way, but some people thought it and interpreted it that way. You know, and so she's apologized.
Sorry to that.
And just let it die.
Mm-hmm. We need to stop encouraging that thing. I'm so sorry. We need to calm down.
I'll be more offended if someone brings this
African Americans
ever again. That's trying to use it against her.
Do you know how many times we say Becky to people? Like, oh my God, Becky. Oh my God. Like, maybe it's because I know how much I diss white people.
I think what has happened
on Twitter, I'm always like, Caucasian control, they've come. Like, I'm talking out loud. So if somebody then says something that's so harmless, she's playing with her daughter, for God's sake. Like, she's just using a name. Do you hate your name
so much? Let me tell you what has happened over the years, and I think the Black African Americans should start moving away from that. It's the internalization of slavery that our forefathers were meant to go. They went through this.
Many of them don't.
Many of them don't even have a clue
of
what those who went through it. Yes,
no longer there.
You can see what he's talking about.
We can't keep internalizing the slavery that happened. It is past. Yes, were there demerits and disadvantages and ills that was perpetrated due to that? Yes.
And
we're off it now.
I'm beginning to even think that people are beginning to milk that thing. If you find it in the LGBT community where, like, oh my God, you're coming out, it's a voice, and then we love you so much and we push them and so because they want to, you know, have his voice or whatever. But now you see people doing that just to catch clout and just to, and I feel like that's what's happening with the Black community. Oh my God, I was oppressed, and oh my God, I was like, calm down. You were late to work. I used to have that girl. Is it because I'm Black? I was like, no, it's because you have poor ethics. Like, nobody's speaking on you for color.
There is a positive, the strength it can take from all of that. That yes, our forefathers did go through this, but look at us today. We're people who survived it. We're survivors. And so, should we keep relieving And keep internalizing those bad experiences.
And don't use these mundane things to downplay the real issues.
Thank you. And that's what I'm worried about. It's like, if we always scream about everything, when actual big things happen, like they kill our sons, or they, you know, like serious things, we're like, oh, they've come again, black people.
So black people in America should take responsibility for their actions in their life and stop
always, white people alone, please.
Playing the card of racism.
Great. Okay, so as young promising man where they that's pigeon, so I have to take it again. As young promising man where they hustle, legit hustle, no date any girl where Yahoo boy don't pull. And that is coming from the one and only celebrity that's